how did dinosaurs make more baby dinosaurs?
Behaviors in dinosaurs is something that's really hard to infer. We have to rely on the fossil record that we have, and one of the really helpful fossils that we can use, or types of fossils that we can use to look at reproductive behaviors, are fossil dinosaur eggs and embryos.
So, did all dinosaurs lay eggs?
Yes, so all dinosaurs that we know of laid eggs. We found dinosaur eggs in the three major groups of dinosaurs, so Ornithischian, Sauropodomorphs, and Theropod dinosaurs. Birds and reptiles today have a wide variety of eggs. They come in different shapes and sizes and textures and colors, and dinosaur eggs seem to be doing the same thing. Some of them have softer shelled eggs, so similar to some snakes and reptiles today, and some of them have hard shelled eggs like birds have today. Some of them are more circular, some of them are more oval.
Some dinosaurs even laid colored eggs, like the pigmented eggs we see in some birds.
Colors in eggs today are based on certain pigments, and those pigments seem to be able to fossilize. Scientists have been able to infer that those types of pigments were still already present in fossil eggs, and so they can look at what color they would have been. Some of them are blue-green eggs, some of them are speckled eggs, some of them are white eggs, so they do vary greatly in like all those different types of eggs.
Much like their living relatives today, dinosaurs would have laid their eggs in nests. But the nests look different from one dinosaur group to the next.
As far as I know, we've never found dinosaur nests in trees, but we have found evidence that some dinosaurs laid their eggs in open nests, so they would have just left their eggs in the wide open air, whereas other evidence seems to point to the fact that they would have had to have buried their eggs, and that's mainly due to the texture of the eggshells. Softer eggshells lose water much quicker, and so to stop them from drying out, they have to be buried, and that also helps to protect them. One of the most famous dinosaur and dinosaur egg fossils is the Sidipodi fossil. It was found in Mongolia, and we can see that there's a skeleton on top, and then underneath here there's a bunch of eggs.
Before the Sidipodi fossil was uncovered in the 1990s, similar eggs in the Gobi Desert had been described as Protoceratops eggs, since Protoceratops is one of the most abundant dinosaur fossils found in Mongolia. Occasionally, paleontologists would find a theropod dinosaur near these nests, and called them oviraptorosaurs, or egg thieves, as it was assumed that they were eating the eggs of Protoceratops.
And then this type of fossil was discovered much later, in the 90s, and that's when it was realized that, you know, the oviraptorosaur, or the, in this case, Sidipodi, was actually lying on top of the eggs. And we can see, here's its legs, and here's its two arms, and so it sort of has its arms wrapped around the eggs, just like a chicken would do today while it's brooding. And so it wasn't eating the eggs or hunting the eggs, it was actually protecting the eggs and brooding the eggs.
It's rare that you can find such a clear example of behavior, in this case, parental care, preserved in the fossil record. But it's not impossible, and every fossil nest has the potential to uncover other dinosaur behaviors.
Some early branching sauropodomorph dinosaurs that buried their nests, there's evidence in the fossil record that those nests are stacked vertically, but they're also stacked horizontally within the rock, and so that tells us a couple of things. Several dinosaurs seem to be together laying the eggs at the same site, and so there's evidence of herd living. Then the vertical stacking, that's sort of evidence through time that they're coming back to the same site on a seasonal basis to lay their eggs, and so that's nest fidelity. There has been some sites where they have found like little trackways around the nest. Some people have hypothesized that those trackways were from hatchling dinosaurs, and even sometimes they get a bit bigger, so that would mean that the hatchling dinosaurs and older ones are hanging out around the nest together, which might be evidence of parental care.
But without further fossil evidence, we may never know for sure. It can also be hard to know exactly which species an egg or nest belongs to, if an adult dinosaur is not found next to it. A lot of the time, scientists can only narrow it down to a possible group of dinosaurs, not a species.
Sauropod eggs are slightly larger, or larger than a lot of other eggs. The oval-shaped eggs, like we see in Sidipodi and other oviraptorosaurs, that seems to be quite diagnostic for that part of the dinosaur tree. And again, like, there's so much variety in egg types across the clades that it's actually difficult to be able to say, like, oh, that's definitely that egg.
Now, with CT scanning, scientists are able to look inside dinosaur eggs at the embryos that are sometimes fossilized within, helping to identify what dinosaurs they belong to. Looking at fossil embryos can also answer questions about dinosaur development.
It's become much easier to study those embryos and to reconstruct them digitally and to look at features that are usually quite difficult to see. Some scientists have looked at the embryonic teeth. There'll be little lines that grow in those teeth. And those lines can tell you how long that tooth has been present in the embryo, and it seems that dinosaurs have longer incubation periods between 3 and 6 months. And there's a sauropod embryo that seems to preserve something like an egg tooth. In birds and in crocodiles, some of them will get a little point on the end of their snout when they're in the egg, and they use that to tap the egg in order to hatch. So that's quite exciting, because again, it tells us that like dinosaur relatives alive today are doing something very similar to what we see in the dinosaur fossil record.